I'm getting too old for this nonsense.
Hey everyone, it is Shadow Harvester yet again with Fall Guys. We got a can of green beans, which I'm not gonna lie, it looks more like peas than beans. But as you can see, it's the ones with like the pea pod, bean pods or whatever. And yeah, it's basically that. The beans are in the little pods and whatnot. So let's get to getting why the getting is good with Squad Show. Yeah, practically the beans are a little more oval shapey than circular, like, well, most pea green vegetables. So anyway, let's get this barcode on the shelves at all costs. We must make it to the finish line. That way we will be sold across the world to all the good beans out there. Yes, beans eating beans. That's probably like carnivorous territory right there. Haha, missed me. Now my weird tin can will not get squashed by the likes of ye. Alright, ow. Might have got a few little dents there in the tip of the can's lid probably got broken there. Alright, there we go. It would probably be wise not to jump anywhere near me, because my lid could be a little sharp. So there's just that. And what are you doing, Ripe Moose 9594? It says you're bouncing back, but all I see you doing is, well, going around and around in the same spot towards the beginning. And that's why we got eliminated, yay. But at least the results kinda, now they're worthless. Sorry to say that, results, but you know, it's a raw deal and you get the short end of the stick. I'm sorry. Another winter disco appearance I see. Darth Skim Milk. That dairy farmer loves the winter somehow, which is not a perfect time at all for dairy farming. I don't know how that works. I know the gist of it, but I don't know enough of it, if that's how you say. Oh man, I'm freezing my can off here. Man, that can is gonna stick to everyone. It's like sticking your tongue on a pole and somehow you get stuck in the winter. Alright, at least I can make it through here. Everybody else managed to do it faster, but you know, can't always get that much of a way to do what you need to do. Okay, there we go. The upper part does not want to cooperate. So I guess I gotta get my barcode somewhere else that will accept me. Oh, okay, fine. We ain't shopping here again. You are not welcome to have my canned good in your store. And here I am, falling, flailing around. Excuse me, you are so lucky I did not fall there, but too bad we couldn't make it there. But we qualified. That's all that matters. That is all that matters. Now we can just keep going. Surprisingly, everything's all nice and green with us in this game, but here I am wearing an orange shirt in the real world. I know, that's weird, right? Track attack. I don't know why my voice does that. It's like, yay, woo, wee, and stuff like that. I don't know why my voice does that. I don't even know to be fair, I don't even know my quote-unquote true voice without any, like, enhancements or random stuff. I'm gonna have to, like, have a day where, like, literally every part of my nasal cavity and my throat and all that stuff doesn't make me sound like this all the time. So, get all that out, and it's like, hello, I am the true Shadow Harvester. No. One of these days, if that ever happens, I will record it. You have my word. You have my word. Alright. So, qualified. Qualified, never forgotten. Because stuff. Alright. There we go. Show me the next round. Rotation station. It's a station that's good for rotation. It's always good to roleplay. Yeah, rotation and roleplaying are not the same thing, I guess. Nope. Well, we gotta rotate our way. If we can do Whirligig in some mild manner fashion, we can do this. Okay, ooh. I can see where that could get a little trick. I can see where this comes in. Okay, it moves, so yeah. Got to be careful. Alright. Okay. So it's this way. Okay. Oh, haha. Made that. And oh boy. I can see where this one gets a little. I'm just going to sit here and be A-okay with myself so I don't have issues. Okay. It's better to just stand there at this point. We're in third. I can do this. Alright. Lost a little bit of time, but not enough. You didn't let me like it. Curse you, game. I actually like this game, I'm not gonna lie. Okay, there we go. We can, like, we just have to push the A button to get it to respond. So, yeah. At least we know something. Which we should know, because we've done it a few times. When we actually like something. Canyon Sunday. That sounds good. A Sunday. Now that got a sun, you weirdo. And surprisingly, it is actually a Sunday when I'm recording. So, yeah. Whoa. It's like all Aztec-y-ish. Some way. I mean, it makes sense. I'm pretty sure there's like an Aztec civilization. Yeah, there's like... No, I think that's Egypt. It's one of the two, but I'm pretty sure it's Egypt, now that I think of it. Yeah, it's Egypt, duh. I only know this because of Yu-Gi-Oh! With the Winged Dragon of Ra being basically a Ra, who is basically a sun god kind of thing. So, yeah. Alright. And now we know how to do this. Okay. At least this doesn't have a giant, like, 30-inch hole. Like a certain game from our past. At least where I left off. From the Fade Passes, when I left back in December. You remember those games. Oh, yes. Alright. It's going good. Okay, big shots. You want to take a shot at me? Go ahead. All these sharks that are in this default picture, as much as I like that costume, I'm not gonna lie. There's something about sharks and reptiles and other random creatures that this game puts in. I mean, there's two right there, Master Chief and Pac-Man, and I almost got cut in half by that axe. Alright. I never thought we'd see Pac-Man, Master Chief, and a can of green beans in the same world. This is the true Smash Brothers. And only Pac-Man is the one that's in Smash Brothers, so. I'd pay $30 to see Master Chief as DLC. No. That's what I get. That's the fan base or whatever, like, $30 just for Master Chief? No, they wouldn't do that. Honestly, though, there's a lot of cool characters that came into Smash Brothers, but I don't like a lot of some of them. I don't care for their characters from, like, Persona, Bayonetta, stuff like that. Those characters just don't interest me. Like... Characters like, I mean, necessarily not exactly DLC characters, but, you know, we got Ridley, we got freaking Wario, we got Sonic, Solid Snake, characters like that, Wolf, and then we got dumb ones like the villagers from Animal Crossing. No, who we need is that damn owl. Well, not an inn, but like a restaurant thing, like Brewster or whatever. And I only know who that character is because I voiced it. The character in like a old Smash Brothers machinima, even though the voice was very dumb and bad, but still. Surprisingly, it's the same machinima I did a voice for Lucario, but again, that wasn't even that good, but oh well. And let's get some hexagon before it's gone. Yum yum, a dish of hexagon. For everybody to enjoy. But some people might be allergic to the hexagoning. Some people might not like this. But it's a mini game. Everybody loves mini games. Except the mini games that are literally talked about, that are practically hated beyond all capacity of the word. But people seem to talk more about the stuff that they hate than the stuff that they like. Even though that it doesn't matter. Things are either overhated or overliked. Believe me, there's things I like. There's things I hate. And no one's going to change those opinions. And I'm not going to change anybody else's opinions, I'm sure. But at the same time, quit talking about it like it matters. Because you people act like, oh, this should have never been made. Oh, I wish I could forget about it. Yeah, but you're the ones talking about it. So, yeah, you're kind of just playing two fields there. You hate something, but yet you talk about it. I hate stuff too, I will admit. But I talk about the people that usually do it. I don't like, oh yeah, you remember this show from this era? Oh, that sucked. Believe me. I can make a whole like hour-long video of talking about shows that people think are like the greatest shows ever. But really, all they did was make you stupid. Not to mention, a lot of the actors and stuff are like really bad and awful people. At least some. And then there's some actors that took their fan base for granted, hurt themselves, did drugs, suicides, stuff like that. And then there's the one that couldn't help it and accidentally got killed or hurt or something. It was never their fault, and those are the types of people that you should miss. The ones who commit suicide, they should be remembered as cowards and stuff like that. Because apparently hurting yourself and stuff like that means you're a coward. But everybody's be like, oh, but they probably had some sad and emotional problems. Yeah, well, I have those too, believe me. I need to shut up before I dig more and more of myself into a trench-like hole that never to be found again. But you get what I mean, right? We all have that moment. Some of us prefer the color blue, some of us prefer the color orange. But we're still fine people. Though I think out of all the colors, red, blue, and pink are probably like the most common colors. Our favorite colors, I should say. Maybe black at this point, because people are going through black like it's crazy. That and purple. So, yeah. I'll stick to my reds and my blues. I like black, but you know, it goes good with blue. So that's why I picked those colors. I don't really care for black and red as much, unless it's like something else. But mine's more of like bruises, because it's like black and blue and maybe a little red all over. Yeah, that's one of the reasons why I made that my default color of choice for anything, whether it's logos or characters. If I could ever actually come up with a decent character that I would use as a default, and someone either make me it, or you see a little like character on the screen underneath me. But everybody asks way too much for, like, it's like, hey, I'll be a voice actor, but I'll only do this for a certain amount of money. It's like, yeah. And then, like, animation fees and stuff like that are just weird as well. I don't care if you do a good job, but most of you are going to do a good job, because, and I respect that. Because you guys took time and effort to learn certain things, but there's a lot of people that have that that just make the stupidest little creations. And then they're remembered for all time as the person who made a really disturbing picture. Alright, only one, wow. Only one fell to their doom. They took a heck of a chunk of that blue out down there. From what I see, there's still some people down there. Yeah, that whole blue is gonna be eaten up soon. I need to start grabbing over here. Because, well, once I destroy these, then there's no way I can get the other ones unless I do like a running jump like this. But even then, and then that happens. Way to go, Shadow, way to go. You are a crazy son of a gun with a can of beans in your head. Shaken, not stirred. All right. Well, yeah. All right. So 1, 2. Yeah. Okay. 1, 2, 3, 4 remain. Okay. All right. So who shall seize victory? Well, actually, let's see where everyone's at. Okay, surprisingly, you did what I could have do. But now you're going down. So it's these three. You're glitching out. You're kind of glitching out. I'm gonna keep doing this until you guys move without having weird flying capabilities. Seriously, all three of these should be falling down there by now. Okay, you're not gonna. Actually, maybe. I don't know. Yeah, I have a feeling this one up here is gonna win because that blue down there is almost taken up, and look how much of the purple is left. So, the Trish 87 is going to defeat Sir Cam Cam. Yes, the big bad wolf and the grandma defeats the Captain Sir with some coconut drink around their waist. Okay, anyway. The green peas, bean things, yeah, that is us. Alright, I'm ending this part here. I am Shadow Harvester. Like, comment, subscribe, and I'll see you next time. Bye-bye.